Hello everyone, welcome to the Digitech Dialogue. The Digitech Dialogue series is an initiative of ET Government. This is an interactive show with the bureaucrats on different milestones in their digital transformation journey. In this series, senior government officials give an insight of digital innovations and use of technologies by their departments and ministries. Today, on behalf of ET Government, I welcome Dr. Vipul Agarwal, Deputy Chief Executive Officer of National Health Authority. Dr. Vipul Agarwal is an IPS officer of 2001 batch of Gujarat cadre. He is a medical doctor turned cop who is known to be pragmatic and proactive officer with more than 20 years of work experience behind him. A meritorious student all his life, he has served as a superintendent of police of Porbandar, Banashankata, and Dahod districts. In his last assignment, he served as a Joint Commissioner of Police Administration of Ahmedabad City, a position with immense administrative responsibilities, human resource, and finance management. Apart from this, he has also served in Gujarat State Health Department as a Mission Director, National Rural Health Mission, and MD, Managing Director of Gujarat Medical Services Corporation Limited. Dr. Agarwal has a master's degree in police management from Usman University, a master's degree in English literature, and also another master's degree in business administration from IGNO. I once again welcome to Dr. Vipul Agarwal.
Thank you very much, Mr. Radhakrishnan. Thanks for giving us an opportunity to be here and present our thoughts before the audience.
Yeah. Sir, I have a few questions. I request you to please give as much as possible information. So my first question, sir, Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana is among the few schemes in the country that is completely data-driven. Yes. It is also to complete 3 years of operations next September this year. And congratulations to you. You have also completed 1 year. What is the latest update that you have? How Ayushman Bharat Yojana is performing entire country except barring a couple of states that...
So we started the scheme on the 23rd of September 2018. And as you mentioned, next month, we are going to have our third anniversary. And so far, it has been a great experience running this world's biggest health assurance project in the public sector. So far, we have been able to empanel more than 22,000 hospitals. And the good thing is that probably it is one of its kind scheme wherein around 50% of our participating hospitals are in the private sector. And that's a very encouraging figure. Apart from that, not only that, of the 20,000 odd crores that has been spent on the treatment of the beneficiaries with the support of the state governments, around 60% of the treatment has come through the private sector participation. So it's a glaring example of how the center, the public and the private sectors have come together to provide to the citizens a scheme that is for the citizens, for the poorest of the poor citizens of the country. And also it is directly taking care of the most serious disease of is the out-of-pocket expenditure makes around 6% of the population going below the poverty line every year as per the data we have before the scheme started. So apart from that, we have been able to create cards for 16 crore beneficiaries of the 54 crore odd we have in the SECC database. And in the last 1 year, despite the COVID pandemic, we have been able to do a lot of awareness, increase the card creation. This year alone, we have generated more than four cards. And this has also created, has led to supporting the government initiatives in terms of creating a backup arrangement, not only for the COVID patients, also for the non-COVID beneficiaries who might have faced a difficulty in reaching out to the public hospitals because most of the COVID hospitals, most of the public hospitals were turned into COVID-only facilities. So it has been a great journey so far. And we have a lot of plans for the future. And I think that in the years to come, this would act as a strong pillar of support for those who need the health services the most and don't have the support in terms of their own earnings to support the healthcare expenditure.
What about the status on these three pending states?
Yeah, so as you mentioned, in May this year, we entered into MOU with the state of Telangana, and now only remain the union territory, the states of Odisha, West Bengal and Delhi now. So Delhi, in fact, in the last assembly last year, they had announced that they would be joining, but somehow, because of some reasons, they are yet to sign the MOU. We are following it up with the states, and I think the states, these all three of these states have their own schemes also, and we still are insisting and ensuring that these the state beneficiaries, in fact, many of the hospitals we have already empaneled under portability, which are providing services. But I think in the days to come, we might get a buy-in from the states, and we might and get these three states on board, but rest of them, 33 states and union territories, are already our partners in the scheme.
You have lakhs of patients, thousands of institutions, a national health authority is an administration to take care of the one of the biggest health schemes in the country. I mean, monitoring and managing the such a large scale operations, I'm sure you deeply require engagement of the technology. Can you elaborate how IT systems working model and who are all the technology partners supporting the National Health Authority? If you can elaborate on the functioning methodology.
Yeah, so as you mentioned, PMJY is one scheme which is 100% data driven and is backed up by a strong IT backbone. So to take care of the core modules and core aspects of transactions in the scheme in terms of beneficiary registration to the admissions, claim, admissions treatment and the claim processing and the payments, the end-to-end entire thing has been made cashless and paperless. And this is possible only because one of the finest IT framework that we have. So we have three core modules of the IT backbone. One is for the beneficiary identification. Second module takes care of the hospital empanelment, and the third module is a transaction management system that takes care of the beneficiary's admission to his discharge and the claim processing. So these are the core modules, but over and above that, we have a strong monitoring and evaluation backbone, which also is IT enabled. We have a very strong three-tier grievance redressal mechanism, and we have the entire call center and the grievance redressal machinery is taken care by IT framework and IT module that we have, which is the central grievance management redressal system. And also we have a very robust fraud and abuse control framework. So the world's best big data analytics company, SAS, supporting us in the fraud, anti-fraud framework that we have. And a state-of-the-art AI/ML capable triggers are being pushed to the states for action. So all in all, it's an IT-driven, data-driven project, and the dashboards that we manage for policy makers and for larger level scheme related policy guidelines and future monitoring, we also have the state-of-the-art dashboards supporting it. So entire thing is being taken care of through IT backbone. We don't have, ours is a paperless, all the inside the office and in the entire system of PMJY is taken care through IT systems.
I mean, on top of the your IT infrastructure, we also hear that you are building some applications as a value addition, like an e-voucher and some of the things. I'm sure this is really helpful to the people, you know, who can take that voucher and get to the hospital where they can access the healthcare. If it is not confidential, can you able to share some update on e-voucher's roadmap?
Although the concept of e-voucher and a paperless transaction system wherein a person-specific and purpose-specific transaction can be enabled in the ecosystem, this idea was initiated through the Chief Executive Officer of NHN under the able guidance of Honorable Prime Minister. This could see the light of the day. But this basic framework is hosted on the DFS and NPCI framework. So NPCI and DFS are providing that support through the network of hospitals and and the receiving banks. So what happens is that in this entire process, there's an entity which has to pay. It can be government entity or a private entity. This entity gets into collaboration or cooperation with its bank. Which the bank would generate the e-voucher. The e-voucher would then come on the beneficiary's mobile as a SMS or a QR code based string. So now this string, can be then used at the merchant side for getting a paperless transaction done. And this is redeemed at the merchant end, because the merchant is then having an engagement with the receiver bank. And the entire transaction is being reconciliation is taking place through NPCI framework. So the entire process, NHA as such per se in the backbone, which is enabling e-voucher, that e-rupee transaction is not, NHA is nowhere involved there to say, but at the same time, what we are doing is NHA is implementing two flagship schemes of Government of India. One is Ayushman Bharat and second is the National Digital Health Mission. So in the days to come, we have many plans for using this e-voucher concept for the entire healthcare ecosystem. In that, we are making a beginning by introducing e-voucher concept in the PMJY scheme. It has multiple applications, as for example, for the diagnostics, we can provide the e-voucher to our beneficiaries to get a diagnostic facility service taken without spending out of the pocket. And at the same time, the post-discharge medication can also be enabled through e-vouchers. So we have some plans and we would put them into action in the days to come. So e-voucher is a Department of Finance initiative, which would be used by all the ministries, all the departments, and not only government. It would also have multiple use cases in the private sector. And we would be using e-voucher for our purpose in the healthcare ecosystem.
Okay. Thank you. We hear that National Health Authority also engaged in consultations with multiple ministries, such as social justice, empowerment, labor and employment, and home affairs, to bring their health schemes also on your IT platform. I mean, is it true, sir? And some efforts are going on?
Yeah, so you're right. Actually, the ultimate objective of the government is to reach to the goal of universal healthcare, as was mentioned in the National Health Policy. And at a step towards that, the first thing is that how to align the efforts of all the ministries to have a single IT platform taking care of all the beneficiary-related schemes for health assurance. For example, many of the health department, many of the government departments are running schemes for their employees, which are of the nature of CGHS reimbursement, but no capturing of data, no information capturing, and how the entire transaction is taking place, that is not available. So, and there might be some cases wherein duplication is taking place. One beneficiary is availing the scheme benefits of two different schemes, but because there's no visibility to the government, we are not able to take care of such abuses which might be taking place. So the first objective is how to align all the ministries and converge their health benefit schemes for their employees onto a single platform. As a step towards that, we have had already the collaborations with the Ministry of Labor and Employment for ESIC workers, for the building and other construction workers, with the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment for the manual scavengers, with the Ministry of Home Affairs for the 40 lakh odd CAPF personnel. So a lot of schemes are in the pipeline, and in the days to come, more and more schemes would similarly converge. This would not only ensure that for a particular treatment, government pays the same amount in the hospitals. Second, it would also ensure data capture for policy formulation and for other aspects which government might be interested in. And third, and most important, duplication be avoided. So deduplication of benefits, as for example, many of the national health programs, one beneficiary might be getting a cataract surgery done, and National Blindness Control Program is funding that, but the same bills are being submitted here also, and he might be getting PMJY benefit also, but we do not have visibility. So to take care of such abuses, deduplication needs to be avoided, and that can only come when all these things converge. So we are working on multiple fronts, and uh, we would try and ensure that as early as possible, we converge our schemes into a single platform.
So in that case, sir, in the IT infrastructure, that NHA that holds with your ABBM JAY scheme and the other ministry scheme, do you mean to say that both the servers will talk to each other in real time to know the updates?
Yeah, so there would not be any mixing of servers to say. We would provide API-based dashboard access to all the ministries for the beneficiaries. See, what is happening is that most of these ministries, as for example, if I say that Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, it might be providing benefits, but those benefits are not getting captured because their purpose is they are not basically dealing with the health related aspects. They are just reimbursing the bills. They might be providing support in terms of cash or other ways, but no data capturing is taking place at their end. So what we would do is when we start hosting their schemes onto our platform, their beneficiaries will get added as a separate set of beneficiaries. They would be making payment for that. So we would be doing an accounting separately for them. At the same time, the patient's treatment would be taken care either on PMJY basis or CGHS basis. And the end-to-end transaction would be captured onto our IT platform. And we would provide access to them in terms of the total transactions done, total amount that they have spent. And like so all these transactions would get captured and they'll be given data dashboard access. They would not, because they are not maintaining any, many of these ministries are not maintaining any record of such transactions. So this would be the first time that they'll start getting access to this information.
Okay. One hypothetical question, doctor. Of course, you are also a medical doctor by profession. I'm sure you will give the answer. See, that means you are building a very robust IT platform that you are giving the more value to the your customers, like, you know, the ministries for their health services are concerned. The same time you build, manage and run the your own ongoing Yojana. I just want to ask you, for example, there are so many public health insurance companies. They might have lakhs of customers. Maybe they may not be below poverty line, but they may be above poverty line. If in case, if any private organization comes in India or abroad, comes to National Health Authority, we would like to use our IT platform for our customers' point of view. Is there any feasibility, possibility that you can see that this platform can extend its efficient service to within the public domain, subject to approval by the government of India and concerned ministry? Do you accept such offers?
Yeah, that's a very good question. In fact, when we started the scheme intended to cover the bottom 40% population, which cannot afford the healthcare services, and that has to be reimbursed 100% by the government. Yeah. But there's a middle section of the population that Niti Aayog uses the term missing middle for that. So there's a middle 20-25% population of the country. That's a significant number. That might be around 30-40 crore. So that population is not so rich as it can afford a healthcare expenditure out of pocket without causing a dent onto their living standards or on their economic level. At the same time, it is not so poor that the government needs to reimburse 100% cost of their healthcare. Now, what we are doing is to take care of such population, we wish to project a model to the government of India. And for that, last year, National Health Authority floated an expression of interest to call and invite the insurance companies in the public and the private sector to participate and start using our set of hospitals, using our set of our IT system and other infrastructure available with NHA, and how can it be used as a public good to take care of the expenses that they might be incurring on setting, because many of these IT companies might not be, all these insurance companies might not be that big that they can spend the amount that NHA has in running the scheme of this magnitude. So we wish to explore the possibility of an arrangement wherein for a scheme like PMJ, a private insurance company might be charging somewhere around 20-25,000 rupees a month, a year, as a premium from the beneficiary or from the client. But can there be an arrangement wherein the same IT system of NHA be used by these private companies and the same sort of insurance be provided at amount of 1,000 rupees, 1,500 rupees instead of 25,000 rupees? And I think if that comes, and we are running that pilot with two or three insurance companies, 18 companies had come forward and participated in that expression of interest exercise, and we have selected two or three companies, and we are now currently running the pilot. Once those pilot results are out, we wish to project that, and we wish to analyze as to whether they can be a cost-effective mechanism of providing insurance to the middle 30-40% population of the middle 20-25% population of the country. And I think 1,500 is an amount which everybody in the middle class can afford, as against 25,000, which is currently the premium. If we see talk about a scheme like PMJY, where 5 lakh rupees insurance cover is provided. So that is exactly the thing that we are thinking, what you have said. And in the days to come, once we are done with this analysis is done, and we are able to arrive at some decent model, we would definitely take it to the policymakers, and then maybe we can come out with some models like this for the larger good of the society.
One more question, doctor, since you are also a police officer. See, for Indian Army, Indian Air Force, Indian Navy, they have a very excellent medical facilities for internally in-house for their complete workforce. When it comes to state police officers, central police officers, they still depend on the public government, public services that we have in the state governments. But a dedicated medical facilities are definitely missing for the people who rising to the occasion during a COVID or non-COVID, always on emergency situations. But is there some suggestion or consideration National Health Authority can put forward to the government as part of their one of the consultations that, you know, yes, there is a need for a police force also to have a similar set of medical facilities that India has for the army personnel?
Here I would like to submit that health being a state subject, it is for the concerned state governments to take a call on their beneficiaries, and police is one of the beneficiaries. In fact, the state government has many other departments also, and these things now apply not only to police, this would apply to all other state because the kind of support, many of the states would not be having a scheme like CGHS in place for the employees. So yes, few states are making a progress and aligning the schemes for their beneficiaries, for their own employees, and they're linking it with the Ayushman, and few states have taken an initiative also in that direction. The thing is that we wish to prioritize first. Our first priority is to strengthen Ayushman implementation and expand the beneficiary base to cover what we are yet to cover in terms of the card creation, in terms of awareness. Simultaneously, we are also taking care of the expansion of the scheme in terms of convergence of the existing schemes. But engaging with the state governments and requesting them is somewhere we want to give it a time, because it is for the state governments also to take a call, whether because that might lead to some change, increase in the expenditure for the state government, because they are also the entire expenditure on their beneficiaries would be done by the state governments. In fact, while I was mentioning, I had mentioned that CAPF scheme has already been conversed. So like for CAPF, 100% expenditure is being done by Ministry of Home Affairs. So likewise, state governments would have to take a call whether they would like to do that sort of expenditure, because if they come into the fold of PMJY, around 50% of the hospitals that would be added to the network would be private hospitals. Now, providing services in private hospitals, are the state governments agreeable to that? Because that would entail some expenditure. We can only provide an IT framework, but we cannot commit an expenditure for the state government employees, because those are 100% to be funded by the state governments. So there are some issues involved there. We want to go slow on that and let the state decide on that. But as and when some request comes from the state, we are very proactively taking that up, and we are providing our IT support to expand the coverage to their employees as and when some state is making any request.
Thank you. Thank you, doctor. Sir, what's the progress on health benefit packages 3.0?
I would like to mention that when we started the scheme, we had a very detailed consultation on the health benefit packages, because unlike the CGHS, PMJY runs on a bundled package construct, because CGHS has different rates for different services, and the cost of services for every patient is different, because one clinical visit, one clinician might be visiting 10 times in case of one patient and 15 times in case of the other patient. And the same treatment might be having different reimbursement for two different patients, depending on the case requirement. Whereas in PMJY, if the patient comes for cholecystectomy, it can be any scenario. We have all costs included in that package, and the same package rate would be reimbursed. Now, over a period of time in the implementation of the scheme, we have experienced that few of the rates, few of the packages which were made, the hospitals are not finding them viable. Few of the packages need revision, otherwise also in terms of the disease to be covered. A lot of state governments have their own packages included. We keep on revisiting them and we keep on including them. So we launched the HPP 2.0 version, and after that we launched the HPP 2.1. Currently, we are in the process of implementing the next version after 2.1. So 3.0, here I would like to explain that 3.0 would be a zero-based exercise that we would do for our packages, and a lot of effort in that direction has already been done. A study is underway since almost 1.5 years by the Department of Health Research under ICMR with the support of PGI Chandigarh. And recently, a report has been submitted to before NHA. We had detailed discussions. We are targeting to implement the revised modality of considering the package costs as submitted by them for the top utilized packages in the first phase. And we want to implement it over a period of 6 months to 8 months, so that there's a gradual shift for the hospitals also. And slowly and steadily, we get accustomed to the new package construct. Ultimately, also think that package revision is one thing. We also have to think about the costing things like the diagnostic releases, DRG, which is prevalent in many other countries. So a lot of thought is going on in that direction also. HPP 3.0 would be implemented gradually. And I think by the 31st of March next year, we are targeting that almost 100% packages should be revamped and made in tune with the current times. And all the redundant packages need to be eliminated. So that's in process very much.
Yeah. Your priorities for this year, and can we see that all the private health companies, their customers can use your NHA platform, IT 2.0 this year?
See, even if that has to happen, as I mentioned, the pilot study is currently underway. As per the cabinet decision, this call can only be taken at the cabinet. There's a process involved to it. So we have to assess that in the entirety, because we have to do the cost benefit analysis, and that can only be possible once this pilot results are out. And we are for it. In fact, we want to create and we want to give a model which takes care of the Indian citizens' requirement and enables us to reach to the universal healthcare in the true sense. So definitely that is there on cards, but I don't see that happening by December, because that's a very small period in between, because we have to assess the, analyze the results of this pilot, then formulate a policy note. We have to circulate for the stakeholder consultation. States are our partners, so we have to assess how comfortable the states are in implementing such a model, because their beneficiary phase and their work is going to increase. So, and after the consultation round, we have to submit a policy note for approval. So that has takes its own time, but definitely, as I mentioned, that we are on it, and in the days to come, we would definitely like to work on something which takes care of the healthcare needs of the entire population of the country.
Who are these lucky three companies?
See, I'll have to check. No, it is not lucky companies. It is just a pilot which is being run. It's a very small beneficiary base. I think 4,000-5,000 beneficiaries only who would be taken up in this as a pilot, and there would not be any sharing of any personal identifier data. Lot of checks and balances have been imposed. So I can share those details. I think that must be in public domain. I can share that, but currently I'm not able to recall the names.
So Dr. Vipul Agrawal, Deputy Chief Executive Officer of National Health Authority, thank you very much for talking to ET Government and sharing your knowledge on the national project AB-PMJY and its roadmap. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.